like presenting a contribution on behalf of interdisciplinary team, dealing with the project complex network analysis, combined networks methods applied to ancient Egypt data in the Old Kingdom. Extending and generalizing the proposed methods in order to enable the assessment of more complex combinations of artifacts, including, for example, tomb locations, tomb relations, and dynamics aspects of the data. Today, I will present one of the research directions on which our team focuses, cybernetic methods, which we used for reconstruction of Old Kingdom administration in the 3rd millennium BC, except the age of pyramid builders. The sophisticated administration in the age of the pyramid builders offers a remarkable time span for research and unique opportunity to analyze the dynamics of a complex society in a diachronic perspective. Although scholarly interest in the Old Kingdom administration has always been relevant, the grasping of its complexity and the tracing of the particular processes which led to changes and innovations of the system have been missing. Their study is crucial because it adds a valuable insight to our knowledge of varying Old Kingdom social and administrative structure. Contrary to traditional approaches relying on statistics and logic, we have utilized number of additional techniques that provide and ensure large data volume processing, processing that may be repeated many times versus manual drawing of graphs, for example. Database consistency, automated grouping people into families, automated family tree building, layout and visualization, count and text-based tagging of titles to distinguish their categories, assessment of nepotism in families based on associative analysis, and etc. So you can see on this slide. In this talk, I will present an overview of our achievements in society development reconstruction, covering both structural and dynamics aspects using complex network analysis and hidden Markov models. We use the term complex network analysis instead of social network analysis because we combine various kinds of evidences from ancient Egypt. Data on individuals, their names, their administrative and other titles, data on architectural features of their tombs, spatial distribution of tombs, and etc. An essential prerequisite for a successful solution of our goals was the creation of an elaborated tool serving as the base for our analysis. A database of officials predominantly buried within the mummified cemetery during the Old Kingdom. This database, named Markov, comprising data about 4,000 500 individuals, was launched in 2006 and has been running continuously since. The database spanned four Old Kingdom dynasties from the 3rd to the 6th The database created in filmmaker prompt includes information about individual persons, gender, provenance, site, phone calls, dating, titles and epithets, biographical references, and alternatively an image of a relevant inscription for group checking, as well as their family relations. In our effort to create a model of the Old Kingdom administrative development, we chose the titulary of viziers, which has served us as a testing sample for the application of various cybernetic methods and modeling. The choice of vizier seems suitable for our intention, since the viziarate functioned continuously from the beginning of the Fourth Dynasty till the end of the Old Kingdom. The structure of vizieral titulary stratified and changed during the Old Kingdom period. The vizieral titulary was interconnected with the development of society and reacted to it. We therefore take a slice of data dealing with viziers and their titles. We can see a sequence of viziers at the bottom, ordered chronologically here. The related dynasty period is shown as a strip at the top of the diagram here. The full set of all titles and epithets held by all viziers consists of almost 500 titles and epithets, whose names are not shown in this slide. Because on this, based on this diagram, we may speculate only on some phenomena of the administration development. For example, it seems that the most complex administration, judging from the number of titles that viziers held, can be observed in early Sixth Dynasty. We have decided to advance the analysis further, using a method based on so-called hidden Markov models. Let me quickly introduce the principle of hidden Markov models. The system that is analyzed is modeled as a state transitional system. This means that the system exhibits specific configurations of internal variables that influence its future behavior. These configurations are called states. It is assumed that future states depend not only on the current state, but not on the events that occur before it. This is called the Markov property. The basic Markov model enables transition using which the system transferred from one state to next one. The Markov model is a stochastic model, which means that the transition between the states are controlled by a probability distribution. In the diagram, you can see these probabilities as numbers attached to arrows representing the transitions. Now imagine that the states are only partially observable. In other words, observations are related to a state of the system, but they are typically insufficient to precisely determine the state. In such cases, we can hide the Markov model into a black box or behind counting as in this diagram. And then we can only observe so-called events, for example, A, B, C, D, and so on in the picture. Also, in this case, the events is in a given state are emitted by the model randomly based on the given distribution. We can define at least three basic tasks based on this model. First, we have set of observations, event sequences, and try to estimate the Markov model. In other words, we learned the model. Second, we have known model and event sequences. Then we can estimate the probability that the sequence was emitted by the given model. Finally, assuming a given Markov model and given event sequences, we can estimate the most probable sequences of state. Let me go back to our data. We have sequences of viziers that defines the chronological order of time occurrences. In other words, we treat each row related to a given title as a sequence of titles occurrences in time. Using the sequences for all titles, we learn the Markov model of title occurrence. In fact, it can be shown that just two states of titles appearance are sufficient. The period when the given title is held by the viziers and the period when the given title is mostly missing from the vizier's titulary. As we try to recover changes in the administration offices of viziers, we have focused on the event when the state of a subset of title changed. That means a period when almost synchronous changes in the position of several titles reflect the development of the state organization. This enable us to identify periods when a subset of titles started to appear, or on the contrary, when a subset of titles almost disappeared. Having such periods identified, we can ask the system which title contribute mostly and probably to such a change. We can see results on this slide. Again, the horizontal line shows the chronological order of viziers. The vertical axis reflects the values of the quadratic average of probabilities of changes in title occurrences, the so-called change index. The blue line at the bottom reflects the change index variable for subset of titles that started to be mostly held, while the red line at the top reflects the change index for subset of titles that almost disappeared from the zeros titulary at the time. We can also see the list of blue titles that appear to be mostly held. So, the position of the first character identifies the vizier for whom the change happened with the highest probability. Similarly, we can see red titles that almost disappeared from vizier's titulary. We have marked the most significant periods of titles occurrences changes by colored ellipses. We can see that the system identifies the same periods that are identified by the egyptologists. The analysis of titulary in combination with the detection of social processes constitutes a method of mapping the development of Old Kingdom Viziriate. We can distinguish several landmarks and development stages of this office. Because of the time shortage, I cannot explain the importance of it in individual landmarks. I choose only one. The rank of Nusra represents the current landmark. In general, the number of administrative titles. Stratification increased. The reconstruction of the administration was mirrored in the vizierial titulary, which was redefined in a new manner. The six titles symbolizing the so-called pillars administration became constituent of the vizier titulary from the mid-5th dynasty onwards. The projection of the top dimensions of particular viziers on the chronological axis shows similar patterns to the landmarks identified in the Old Kingdom Vizieral Institution. The dimensions of Vizier's tomb oscillate from 8,000 square meters in early 4th dynasty. You can see it here. To 29 square meters in the mid-6th dynasty. In assessment of tomb dimensions, we are aware of the tomb type, mastaba versus local tomb, and of the late Old Kingdom popularity of reusing at a tomb or burying within an ancestor tomb. As for the largest area, there are four obvious periods with tomb areas surpassing 1,000 meters. The first half of the 4th dynasty and the turn of the 4th dynasty and the reign of Nusera and King and the reign of King Tete. So I will continue very quickly. I show you the last slide because there is no time to explain this wonderful graphs. So, processes and causal links between events can be detected and better understood not only through discoveries, both by uncovering ancient Egyptian monuments, but also using new research approaches applied to already known data and pieces of knowledge, such as the method of complex network analysis. Thank you for your attention.